Hello YouTube, and welcome to this Train Sim World video. This is the first time I've ever played this game. And yeah, it's Train Sim World. It's not the newest version, it's the first version called Train Sim World 2020. It's a cheap bundle on Steam, I installed like a couple of months ago and I thought, why not? So yeah, I just thought I'd do this quick scenario on the Great Western Main Line. It's a near HST, it's going to take 45 minutes, it's called Westworld. You're scheduled to drive a high speed service out of London to the West Country. When ready, head over and get things set up ready for departure. Trains involved, Class 43, GWG, I'm not sure what that stands for. So yeah, Sunday 21st of May, it's in the evening, starting at London Paddington, let's go. So I have installed, I have actually bought Train Sim World 3 in the Steam sale, but I currently don't have enough space on my computer to install it, so yeah, I might end up in uninstalling this and installing Train Sim World 3 instead. We'll see. But I want to play a few of the routes on this game first. Since I already have these routes from the original Train Sim World, and I might, be able to play them in Train Sim World 3, we'll see.
We've been called in to cover for a driver who's been delayed on another service. You're needed to take the train out to Reading, where the driver will continue the service as scheduled.
And you got the woman that talks like she's in a... on the 1980s FM radio. Yeah, these are a little bit laggy. That might be because I'm recording. So, yeah, this is... I might have to turn the graphics settings down a bit. Just so... let's turn it down a little bit. Let's turn that volume up a little bit as well. There we go. It does look nice, doesn't it? There we go, that's a little bit smoother now. So it doesn't look as good as the newest Train Sim World, but it looks still better graphics than Train Sim Classic. Let's have a little look on board while we're here. It's the inside of the HST, which looks pretty posh, to be honest. Not bad at all. What a nice interior. All these sliding doors. Can't go through there. Not sure if I've ever been on a HST before. I think I might have done when I went to Cornwall to St Ives on holiday back in 2015. I think that's probably been that's the only time I can remember. Right, so this looks good. So when you right click, sort of fixes the view, and then if you right click again, it sort of right click the mouse moves. So let's see. A lot of motion blur going on in this game, which I'm not a huge fan of. Right, set the headlights to day and reverse it to forward. So headlights to. Versa to forward, so that's that one. Press the tab key to bring up the dispatch menu. That will unlock the doors. Wait for the passengers to load. good, doesn't it? Shots as well. So three takes you to the back of the train, F2 to the front of the train. No passenger view in this, unfortunately. So if you want to get a passenger view, you have to go in there yourself. It's a good though, the HST and the GWR. Livery. It does look good. Let's press the tab key again and we'll lock the left doors. Doors are closed. Set the train brakes to running. Brakes. Signal permitted, apply power to get moving. We've got a green signal. I presume the controls are the same. Yep, they are. It's A to increase throttle, D to decrease throttle. And you've got your apostrophe to apply the brakes, semicolon to release the brakes. So the controls, the throttle and brake controls are the same as Train Simulator. One is for driver's view, press 2, and 3 for your exterior views. 4 doesn't do anything. You don't have as many views as you do in Trains and Classic, although I'm playing an old version. Appear to be gaining any speed now. Not sure if that's something I'm doing wrong. It does look good, doesn't it? So, throttle's not working. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Seems to be gaining power now. The HST is a pretty slow train and accelerates. So it'll take a bit of time to get up to speed. So press 3, we get the rear view. This is London Paddington. Our next stop is Reading. We're due there at 9:55. It's currently 19:33. I'm going to follow this motion. Setting to turn that off. Maybe there is. But being a train sim classic player, I'm not really used to that. So. It does look good. Taking lots of screenshots. It's going to notch 5. Speed limit coming up, so I'm not used to this HUD system, so it's going to take a little bit of getting used to. It's not even telling me how far it is to Reading, so yeah. Look at that sun, that looks nice. The arrow keys switch from the driver's seat to the guard seat. because this was like one of the original, one of the first routes to come with the game, the Great Western Main Line. It's at least 4 years old, this route. Second, so you can now increase the power up to 100. But it's saying we're speeding probably because there's this, the back of the train hasn't passed the speed post. So yeah, the sounds are okay, but they're not as good as the new version. We have improved the sounds a lot in this game. The graphics as well. You know, the sky looks okay, but not as good as it does now. I mean, overall, I still prefer Train Sim Classic to Train Sim World. It's going to take some getting used to this game, but I'm ready to try something new. Of course, my PC is a few years old now, so it doesn't run this game as well as a modern machine would. My machine does run Train Sim Classic better than Train Sim World. So it's 30 miles to the next station. In Train Sim World 2 and 3, that distance appears in the top left corner there, but in this old edition it doesn't. Yeah, they have made a lot of improvements to the game. To be honest, I probably prefer it off. What a huge fire machine there. And it's probably just slowing down the frame rate as well, if anything. Of course, I am recording, so that'll have it a reduction on frame rate as well. Passing a slower class 166, which will be a stopping service. So yeah, I don't know if it's still the same, but class 166 trains did the stopping services on this line, and HSDs do the fast route. Although there is overhead wire, so there must be electric trains which do this service as well. As HSDs and class 166s are both diesel, of course. 27 miles to go to Reading. unfortunately there's no fly-by shot view that you get in Train Sim Classic, unfortunately. All passage view. Would be good if they added to that to the game. Trying Train Sim World 3 soon, and hopefully I'll like that better. I'm not sure what routes come with it. Let's turn the power down a bit. It's getting close to top speed. So in the top right corner there, it tells you how far the next signal is. And whether the signal's green, amber, or red, so that's a helpful feature which you don't get in Train Sim Classic, of course. And you also have your action points in the top right hand corner as well, which are like the career points that you get in Train Sim Classic. I'm driving a bit over the speed limit now, so just plan a little bit of braking. It's really rocking about now. It's just really rocking up. Don't know if they're this shaky in real life. Not supposed to be a very comfortable ride on HSTs. Reading will be the final stop or not. And if one gets rid of all the hoods, so you can drive hoodless if you want, if you know the route well. But I don't, so I'll keep that up. Do have this route in Train Sim Classic as well, so I'll probably do some videos on it at some point. ...20 miles to go to Reading. have to be honest, I don't find driving on mainline routes the most exciting. The West Coast Mainline is the most varied. Some other games I'm planning to do is Grand Theft Auto 5. I'm going to play that. And also Black and White 2, which is an old God. Is pretty well at around 123 miles an hour. We should arrive in just about. It's not a screen. This thing eats up the miles pretty quick. I think in real life the HSTs go all the way from London to Paignton and London to Penzance, or at least they used to anyway. I know a lot of the services have been replaced by more modern trains, such as the Voyager or the Class 800. So a lot of them are, you know, being retired from service, which is a shame, but all things must come to an end. So if you want to go on a HST, now would be the time to do it before they all get retired. And we'll probably start seeing these on preserved railways before too much longer as well. So we're currently 3 miles away from Reading, so we're going to have to start thinking about braking soon. The brakes on HST aren't that great, so probably going to have to start braking from around 2 miles away. We've got a 95 coming up pretty soon, so I think I'm going to start braking now. Just bring it down nice and slowly. Single yellow and a track change. Should we run just about on time? Slowly. Be careful because that red signal. Train brake into full service, into neutral, and pull and lock the doors. Doors are open. Not sure if this is it, or whether there's something going somewhere after this.
Again for helping us out. Hopefully the other driver will be along shortly.
Okay, so got to disembark now. So let's try shutting the thing down. Let's see if it comes off. See if we can turn the engine off. course. That sounds nice as the engine just spooling down there. That's really well done. Anyway, let's get out now. Close the door. Go. We finished London Paddington to Reading. Arrived 1 minute early, and very good stopping accuracy as well. So that's earned us some points. So we'll continue. We've earned a gold medal. So did very well on that scenario. So there we go. Then that was my first play at Train Sim World. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next Train Sim video. But for this video, that's all for now, and thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Bye for now.